Nebraska Public Media Sports, your home for championship sports, is live from the Bob Devaney Sports Center in Lincoln, Nebraska for the NSAA Volleyball Championships and our second title tilt of the morning has Cedar Catholic, the Huntington Cedar Catholic Trojans, taking on the Norfolk Catholic Knights. And welcome in once again, everyone, to the Bob Devaney Sports Center here in Lincoln. A day long of action right here on Nebraska Public Media as we bring you six state championships. Kathy, we move now to Class D1 between a couple of teams that are very familiar with each other.
Absolutely. This will be their fourth time that they've matched up, so they're very familiar with one another. They've kind of got, they've got experience playing each other. They've got notes on each other, you know.
Yeah.
And as we talked to them, they're excited to play again because, again, they're two. It's 2-1. Norfolk Catholic has the lead. The last win was Cedar Catholic. So both of them are ready to match up here one more time. Again, because they know each other very well, they know that they are going to have the best,
right,
you know, from the opponent. But again, Norfolk Catholic trying for their first state championship. I mean, they come in as the number one seed. Now Cedar Catholic comes in as the number seven seed. This will be 10 years since they last won a state championship as well. So two teams really have things that they want to accomplish here. They've seen each other, so are feeling very confident coming into this final championship match.
And the question always is, Kathy, right, is it because Cedar Catholic won the last battle, does that mean they've figured it out? Or does that mean the Norfolk Catholic let up a little bit in the third battle, and so it's going to be an interesting kind of juxtaposition between the two?
It's really a chess match, and again, your game plan.
Let's take a look at maps and brackets for both of these teams. We mentioned both from the northeastern part of the state, northeast Nebraska, the area called Siouxland. Cedar Catholic and Norfolk Catholic. Norfolk Catholic just a couple of blocks off of South 24th and West Norfolk Avenue, 120 miles from right here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. A little bit further trip for Hardington Cedar Catholic, which has a long tradition of great athletics. Let's go down to the third member of our crew down courtside. Let's go to Anna Bellinghausen.
Hey, Larry. Well, Kathy, you said it. Cedar Catholic was placed as a seventh seed in this tournament. I asked Coach about it, and she said, I don't think my team is a seventh seed. I know we have the potential to be number one. It's just going to take that extra effort today, and it all starts right now.
Thank you very much, Anna. It should be a good one in D1. Familiar foes for the fourth time this year. Who's going to take home the hardware? We'll find out when we come back.
A lot of land comes with a lot of work. The Kubota MX Series is ready to help. You can mow, move hay bales, grade, and clear brush and snow. Equipped with a cab for any conditions. Loader lift capacity for jobs of all sizes. Hydrostatic or gear transmission options. The Kubota MX Series. For more information and participating Nebraska Kubota dealers, KubotaNESports.com.
In 2021, over 400 children in Nebraska were adopted into their forever home.
For Nebraskans who decide to adopt, you are a beacon of hope for children who need it most.
For those considering adoption, you have a unique opportunity to change a life for the better.
It doesn't take a perfect family to make a difference in the life of a child, and more families are needed.
Thank you to all Nebraskans that have adopted or are seeking to adopt a child from foster care.
For those considering adoption, please call
1-800-7-PARENT.
Have you heard about FAFSA?
It's like a form you fill out.
Fill it out and you get money for college.
Easiest way to get money for college, hands down.
FAFSA.
It's a life hack.
It's your way in.
So you want to help me pay for college? I'm down.
Heck yeah.
Definitely.
How is this not trending on all the things?
It took me like 30 minutes to fill out.
So easy.
How much am I gonna get?
This is a hidden gem.
Fill out your FAFSA.
FAFSA.
Drink water, buckle up, fill out your FAFSA.
These are the hands of our farm, working for the future with care, recovering from the unexpected with the strength of a helping hand, celebrating victories big and small together. We know this operation like the back of our hands. Having an insurance partner who understands our needs is vital. We're part of the Farmers Mutual of Nebraska family. We're there always alongside you.
Good morning and welcome to the Bob Devaney Sports Center and the 2022 Nebraska School Activities Association State Volleyball Championships. Today's championship match in Class D1 features the number 7 seed, Hardington Cedar Catholic Trojans, and the number 1 seed, Norfolk Catholic Knights. The NSAA is proud to recognize our premier corporate partners, Farmers Mutual of Nebraska, the Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association, and Nebraska Orthopedic Center for their outstanding support of NSAA activities. And now let's meet the teams. First up, here are the Cedar Catholic Trojans. Number 1, Lainey Cottle. Number 2, Grace Wortman. Number 4, Annika Keen. Number 5, Lexi Eichhoff. Number 6, Faith Christensen. Number 7, Ella Bowers. Number 8, Josie Becker. Number 9, Meredith McGregor. Number 10, McKinley Lammers. Number 11, Lindsay Hamilton. Number 12, Milena McGregor. Number 13, Lauren Berniker. Number 14, Caitlin Arns. And number 20, Katie Jones. The assistant coaches are Jamie Walter and Becky Jones. The head coach for the Trojans is Danae Buss. And now let's meet the Norfolk Catholic Knights. Number 2, JC Wolf. Number 3, Aubrey Barnes. Number 4, Kenzie Jensen. Number 5, Sidonia Wattier. Number 6, Sailor Fisher. Number 7, Addison Kaur. Number 8, Allison Brungard. Number 9, Avery Yostin. Number 11, Hannah Brummer. Number 12, Piper Craig. Number 15, Chanity Robles. Number 17, Morgan Miller. Number 18, Danielle Carney. And number 22, Hannah Hazing. The assistant coaches are Bridget Friedenberg and Kira Sheath. The head coach for the Knights is Michaela Beller. Today's officials are Brian Reese and Kendra Jensen. The bench official is Jackie Steiner. The line judges are Jason Carper and Sylvester Rhodes. And now, let's play state championship volleyball.
She was talking.
Should be a good one here in D1. Cedar Catholic, the Trojans, 25-10, taking on the top-ranked Norfolk Catholic Knights. Looking for a first-ever state championship for the Knights of Norfolk Catholic. They were here in 2020, led by Michaela Beller. They finished a runner-up back in 2020. That's the only other time they have been in a state championship match. And back from that team is Chats Robles, who will lead the way with the attack for the Knights. Robles, a dynamic senior outside hitter, 5'10", averages about 15 kills per match.
Yep, she's a lot of fun to watch. She's smooth out on the court, energy, just real bubbly too, person out there. But again, can she swing at the ball?
Yeah.
Yes.
1,000 kills, 1,000 digs for Chach. Yeah. She's headed to Wayne State next
so
year.
Let's think about that
right?
combination.
No, I was thinking the same thing. I was right with you. We just saw another outstanding performance from someone heading to Wayne State. We start a little soon. Is that what happened?
A little
anxious. Yeah, you know, let's get going right away.
Yep, before the whistle.
Underway now. Sent back by Robles. Now for that offside. Pounded down the line and in on the kill by Cottle. Lady Cottle with a dynamic swing.
Cottle, you know, herself, 12 kills per set. I mean, we're going to have two big outsides doing a lot of swinging back and forth and big plays. Both teams are going to need to make sure they settle down and know there's going to be big swings.
Yeah.
We have big time swing hitters on the outside. So
there's the other big outside hitter. Yeah.
Yep.
Chach Robles, we mentioned she's going to Wayne State, and the reason interesting is because we just saw Bommert with 42 kills to win a state title for Howells Dodge. She's also going to Wayne State, and we know Wayne State, one of the top volleyball programs in the country. There's so many.
I was going to say, it's just been fun that, again, so many of our state colleges are doing so well. But a lot of it is because they're relying on players that we're going to have the opportunity to see here in today's matches.
Right up there by McGregor. Leads to the point for the Trojans.
Cottle,
3-1 here early.
Yeah, Cottle just really knowing where she's at and knowing what spaces are open on the court. She got pulled inside and worked that hand and pushed it to the end.
Into the block, sit back. Cottle rolls it over, but not there. In the middle, the tip try. Into the net is called on Cottle. And now back to serve for the Knights. Addie Kaur. Addie, a 5'9 senior, averages 6 kills per match and gets the ace right there. How about Addie Kaur came into this state tournament with 47 aces on the year.
Or didn't play as a junior.
Overpass! Got it! Sorry, Kathy.
Nope, go ahead. Nope.
Boy, you saw that coming, right?
Yes. Wow. That's trouble.
That's tough serving right there by Addie Kaur that leads to the kill by Chots.
Right. And that was what I was going to say. Addie Kaur has had a great year serving. And she didn't play as a junior, but wow. Come in and really been a major contributor. Up again.
Powering through, but knocked down. Oh, good scramble by the Knights to get the point.
I just like the strong decision. The ball popped up. Robles is right there and says, here you go. Giving it back.
Right side cross court, what a terrific shot. Allison Brungardt.
Brungardt did a nice job seeing the defense open area, that far sideline. She just took that sharp angle here. You can see underneath that block, really a lot of nice space over there. And capitalizes.
Last year as a sophomore, Brungardt moved to that right side and she's been terrific over there.
You know, and that's the other thing we talk about these players. They're playing one position one year, and next year they're playing another position and doing what's necessary to make their team better. But again, their versatility, their skill levels are very high. You know, Norfolk Catholic has really had some injuries and illnesses and different things through the year, so they've played a lot of different positions and done a lot of different things with lineups and so forth. And while that may seem hard at the time, it actually prepares you for situations, and then you're ready if circumstances come up.
Ace by Robles.
Just tough serving here by Norfolk Catholic right out of the gate.
60 aces coming in here to state.
Yeah,
serve and block and some great defense going on right now for Norfolk Catholic.
Right, serving to set themselves up to be able to stop at the net, control what the offense can do.
That's Sailor Fisher, the setter. As you're seeing Norfolk Catholic running a 6-2 system.
A 6-2, that means you've got plenty of outsides, right?
Means you got a lot of hitters to hit and opportunities to get big aggressive swings.
The 2021 Class D1 State Volleyball Championship game showcase a matchup of number one ranked Howells Dodge taking on number three ranked Archbishop Bergen. Despite losing the first set, Howells Dodge kept on fighting, led by sisters Ellie and Grace Bomber. The sisters came alive in the third and fourth sets with a combined 25 kills. The two finished with a match-high 23 kills for the Jaguars. The sisters' dominance proved to be too much for Archbishop Bergen to handle as Howells Dodge completed their mission by winning their first volleyball championship.
And of course, Howells Dodge drops down a class to D2 and makes it back-to-back. They won earlier this morning in a great five-setter with Overton, which will all, they return everyone for next year. So look it up for Overton.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Effective timeout there. Just needed to get the ball back in their hands and timeout just to settle down a little bit. Tough serve. We've seen both teams really being aggressive at the service line.
Good block. Block has been big here early on for Norfolk Catholic. Oh, good work out of the net. Nope. They're going to call.
Yep.
It went out.
Nine gens immediately signal.
Overpass, but not down. The overpass goes for the kill. Good bounce there for the Trojans.
Yep. Yeah, I think there's some question there and change of mind on the sub.
Yep. Scramble here. Back in system for the Trojans. Down the line of the kill by Melina Greger.
Greger, nice job recognizing that line. Norfolk Catholic is giving that line and great execution. You get a chance to see deep corner open.
Not quite on top, and that's long, and Trojans now rattle off a few in a row.
Just kind of settling in, it seems to be. And three in a row.
Battle, stop the run, good swing in the middle.
Robles really does a nice job from that back row attack, and they utilize her back there. And you'll see her just a very diverse attacker. You'll see her hit quick in the middle also as she runs through that front row, mix it in up.
What a great shot there by Keen. Annika Keen right in the back line. Here's head coach Danae Buss in her ninth season. 186-97. That's an impressive record.
Well, and she's super. This team is super emotional after their win yesterday. A lot of celebration and energy. And talked to coach about that. She said, "We've just grown up and grown into this, and it's just so exciting to see."
Yeah.
And again, big swings like that. Great work that they're doing. It's fun and very rewarding.
Down. down the line, but just a bit wide. Cedar Catholic right back in it here in set one.
And I think that's the thing when you've seen a team so many times too, that you just settle in and you know that you need to be patient and stick with your game plan. And it seems like Cedar Catholic is just settling in here a little bit and getting comfortable.
Good up. Nice reaction there by Keen in the back row, but couldn't get it over.
Tough ball there before Cottle.
Yeah.
But seeing great defense play on both sides.
Here's Hannah Hazing in to serve. Sophomore defensive specialist. Waste no time, run in the middle.
Eichhoff, nice job getting in that quick transition. Slices it off the edge of the block.
She's glad to be back on the floor this year in the state championship. It was last year when Cedar Catholic was making its run through state. We were going through warm-ups in the morning of the district final, and she rolled her ankle, was out in the district final, and obviously when you make replacements like that late, you know, you can impact your success, and it certainly did. Good angle there, wow, by Robles. Pulled out of the net.
Oh, great.
Good up the back, yeah, oh, JC Wolf. That's long. Oh, they're gonna say point. They're gonna say there was a touch. You saw the up official see the call from the line judge, said there was a touch, and Cottle gets the kill. Oh, sure.
Yep.
Good eyes by our line judge.
I was confident right away. Yep. Just a matter of seeing it by the up official.
Meredith McGregor. After the ace into the tape. Back to serve now goes Addie Core. Tough serve. That didn't clear the tape or if it was blocked, but it was a point either way for the Knights. Very explosive by Cattle.
Cattle right on top of that ball, I think almost hit off the top of the head of the blocker, but she just jumps really well, quick arm swing. Very athletic.
That's a smart shot. Just rolled that off the fingertips, and McGregor gets the kill.
Yep. Take a ball and do something better with it. Wasn't one she could get her hitting hand on, so took it with that left hand.
Block big on the right side. That's Brungart.
Oh, looks like, again, Josie Becker really did a nice job on this setup. Pushes that ball in the middle of the court, but great block and team over there.
16-15 now, Norfolk Catholic on top. Fourth time these two teams have met on the year. The first two times they played, it went to Norfolk Catholic. They won 3-0 and 3-1. Cedar Catholic came back on October 25th in the postseason to win it 3-1, which means Norfolk qualified, Norfolk Catholic qualified via the wild card. All even at 16 here in the first. Free ball over, opportunity here. And the Trojans couldn't keep it alive.
Yep, those are tough.
Yeah. Robles with the serve. Good pass.
Tough ball, long ways to get it to the outside. Just hung in a little bit low and inside. So tough ball for the attacker there.
Back-to-back points out of that timeout for the Knights. Tipped into the middle, not down. Back row. Swing by Clottle was dug by Robles, and Robles can't handle that one. Josie Becker.
Yeah, Josie Becker again in the mix, setting up a strong block. And she's going to, she knows she's facing Robles across the net. And so key is being solid and strong.
Just got the touch on it. Sometimes out of that back row like that, you want to get the touch down to let the back row handle it.
Ugh. Yeah, tough.
And the ace.
Just tough serving.
Yeah.
We've really seen the attack from the service line. You get a chance to see that again. Challenging, putting at the seams, making passers make decisions.
Sailor Fisher with that last ace, and you look at the numbers from the service line for the Norfolk Catholic Knights. They have players coming into this state championship with 45 aces, 47, 59, 32, 26. It's just it's a tough serving Knights squad.
Well, and you can control so much what the opponent can do with that tough serves. And so serves to set up your block defense and limit the options of the opponent. And if you can keep that going, you really have the edge and can frustrate an opponent.
...2017 3-0 run out of that last timeout for the Knights of Norfolk Catholic. We'll see what happens here after the Cedar Catholic timeout. Well, good angle, nice point. Josie Becker again.
Yep, effective timeout there, but it started with a good pass, and that was key. Laney Cottle stepped in. She does that in the back row. She's a primary passer back there and sets her offense up.
A little tight to the net. And into the net violation.
Those always make me nervous also, too, just the safety in there on those tight ones and going up aggressive.
Oh, what an op. Great job by Katie Jones keeping that alive. And then Jones steps in to take the secondary set. Bumped over. Opportunity here for the Knights off the free ball. And the slide. Got it.
Great job by Kenzie Jensen coming around on that slide. We talked about both these teams being scrappy and great defense. Katie Jones there making a big dig, but really Nice finish, Kinsey Jensen coming around that backside, bringing it back across to that right side on her swing.
They're so difficult on those when you get outside your platform, right, to handle that and get a nice pass up.
Yep. Platform and control, and again, the angles as far as the trajectory of the ball.
Off the touch, got the kill. Swinging a kill by McGregor.
McGregor doing a nice job here, getting off, being aggressive as she comes in for that attack. See to the outside. She had two blockers there, but slices it through.
Exploded on that one with a kill by Cottle.
Great swing there by Cottle. Fun to watch her out on the outside too. Very energetic. Gets off the floor really quick. Look at that elevation. Right underneath the blockers.
...21-all here in set number one. Good battle between these two very familiar foes. There's a look at Danae Buss. Last championship won by Cedar Catholic was back in 2012. It's been 10 years since they won a title. They were here in back-to-back years in 17 and 18, but finished as a runner-up both times. What happens here late in set number one? Off the top of the block. Trojans in the middle. What a swing, Lexi Eichhoff.
Great job there, too, to push middle. You know, everything was going outside, and that, and the center was off the net, but Eichhoff did a great job adjusting, sliding over, giving herself a view, and being able to swing through the ball.
Grace Wortman with the serve. Rolled in, handled easily. Middle again, is that in? No, just wide. Ran that quick middle again. Back to even. So Hazing back in now will serve. Three ball opportunity here for the Knights. Ran the middle, got the kill. 23-22.
Addie Core turning the ball, getting in the middle. She's got a block, two blockers on her. Excuse me, one, but turns it off to the side. She saw that help coming in from the and gave her that indication to go the opposite direction.
Two away are the Norfolk Catholic Knights from set number one. A little tight to the net. Couldn't get it over.
Hannah Hazing serving tough. Both balls have really challenged and not resulted in great passes for the Trojans.
Set point here in the first. Not yet, says Lainey Cottle.
She says that a lot. I got other ideas.
That's right. All right, set point number two upcoming. Off the block and out. Cottle again. Back-to-back kills. Evens it at 24, and we've got extra points here in set one.
Tremendous job pushing that into the hands and then flicking it out of bounds.
What a for the Trojans, trying to sneak by and squeak one out here in the first. 3-0 run. And the ace on set point. What a run for the Trojans. They survived two set points, going a 4-0 run, and Cedar Catholic takes the first. The ace, Katie Jones, knocking him down. Trojans take the first.
Life is full of milestones. Let Wayne State's graduate programs be your next big moment. Whether you work in education, criminal justice, business, public relations, human resources, information technology, or sports and recreation, our programs provide pathways to the next level in your career. Flexible and online, a Wayne State graduate degree helps you write that next big chapter in your life without having to put your life on hold.
All right, it's time to talk about us. Not him, not her, not them. Us. Thanks to us, things have been great. In fact, you can find us just about everywhere. Your food, that's us. Your food's food, that's us too. Your fuel, that's us. And should anyone out there happen to doubt us, by all means, just watch us.
Electricity. It makes life easier, more productive, brighter, possible. Yet we only think about it when we don't have it. The next time you're doing, well, anything, think about how electricity makes it all possible. And know we will be there, powering your every day, every day.
Championship. Cedar Catholic just took set one, and when they arrived on Wednesday night, the first thing they did, they sat down from dinner and they watched Husker volleyball sweep Indiana on this very court. And here those girls are on the same court with an opportunity, and they were talking to their coach about how cool it would be to play out there, the same floor as Husker volleyball, and now they have their chance.
Yeah, Anna, thanks very much. I think it's kind of, that's one of the gems of this state, is being able to come in here and having these athletes play for a state championship on the same floor that they see the Huskers play on night in and night out.
Absolutely, and just, again, that opportunity to step in here and see that and know what else has happened on this floor.
Yeah. You
know? Just a really great to NSAA and university be able to partner in
with that. Work that out. Open up set number two, Cottle with the kill. And the ace. Boy, they have been tough from the service line over the last 6 or 7 points. And that time it's Grace Wortman.
But you talked too about Norfolk Catholic earlier, some of their stats. If you look down the stats too, the ace is coming into the tournament 48, 20, 21, 50, 35, 31. So both teams really are strong and assertive from that service line. So we're going to see them both challenging each other.
Understanding the importance of the serve and the emphasis on the serve.
Everybody says got to win the serve and pass game, you know, and right now, both of them are putting each other through the ring in the test.
Another kill by Cottle. Good start here for the Trojans in the second.
That's her eighth kill, I believe, already. Cottle 8 out of 16, hitting 312.
top of the block. Good up.
Great hustle. Free ball, though. See what they do with it.
Finally put away. Robles gets the kill. But boy, great defense on the Trojan side.
Absolutely. Katie Jones is scrambling out in the back row, getting balls up.
Block was there in the middle. Not sure if it didn't clear the net, but either way, it's a point for the Knights.
Cedar Catholic trying to run around behind, and the blockers did a great job staying focused and keeping track of her.
Good serve, tough serve, leads to the point. Wadier back to serve. Wadier just a freshman. And right there, serving tough. Free ball here for the Trojans. Bump set. Down the line.
Wow.
Connell pounds it down the line.
That's one of those kaboom shots.
Yeah.
You know, nothing in front of her. Just the sharp angle, you know, to get on top of the ball, the velocity. Defense was there, but look at 3 feet in front of her. She's in position.
Service error that time. Handed up by Barnes. Check that wolf in the back.
Laney Cottle again coming up big with his swing. Ball inside. Just knocks the block off the net.
Laney Cottle now back to serve. Mark Tipp was a little behind, not much you could do with it, but Brungart with the kill.
Just the decision making out on the court too of the attackers, seeing what type of ball they've been given, what the opportunities are in front of them as far as the block or open spaces on the court.
Back to serve, Lauren Berniker. Berniker, sophomore middle. Brungard again, right down the line. Oh, good job to keep it alive. What a play by Connell. Wow. Brungard the other way, powered through the block, gets a kill.
Great finish there by Brungard. Look at the scramble, the effort, that extra effort of Cedar Catholic. I mean, popping that ball up, keeping it alive. That's one of the things they talked about this year. They talked about that early on in the game, extra effort in a timeout. And they kind of grabbed onto that, coach said. And just, we know if you just give that little extra effort, good things are going to happen.
Call that one an ace by Sailor Fisher. Side of the block.
Jensen turning that ball. She's pulled over to the right side, and the blockers were coming from that side. Takes it back. She has more court to swing at. Finds success.
Free ball opportunity. There's point guard again. She is undersized at 5'7" on the outside, but she's got some hops.
She gets up there, and she knows because of her size, she's got to hit a little bit different. She isn't getting on top of it or down, so she tools the block, finds those seams. And I love that faster tempo. She came in there a lot quicker.
It was one. One Cedar Catholic.
Good run from the service line for Sailor Fisher before that error. Keen now back to serve for Cedar Catholic. Just inside the line. There's Kinsey Jansen again.
Jansen doing a great job getting in that quick transition. Always like to beat a block. She's got two up there. She still finds a way to get it around and in.
Good numbers for Jansen. Three swings, three kills, hitting 1,000. There's a free ball for Hardington Cedar Catholic. Right on the back line. Good baseball there by McGregor. McGregor will head to the bench, and in to serve is Grace Wharton. Middle again. Is that Eichhoff? It is. Eichhoff with the kill.
Her transition work, she's just finding a way, getting off, getting back in there, making sure she's eligible, and she's just beating the block.
There was a touch, and that's going to be a point for the Knights.
Both middles here really doing a nice job getting involved in the offense, making great shots with what's in front.
It's 4 for 4 for Kinsey Jansen.
Yep, pretty good numbers. I keep setting her.
Yeah. That's another person you want to keep setting, Lady Cottle.
She's so consistent on the outside. And she can take a bad ball just because of her quickness and her jumps, you know, gets her up there.
Today, Bus said the key to this match for the Trojans of Cedar Catholic was, one, they need to serve tough, and two, they need to pass. And when they started passing better in that first set and then served well in the end, that's when they came from behind to take that first set.
Great.
Just a bit long. Nice adjustment, but too long.
Yeah, great effort there on a tough ball.
Sidonia Wadiger back to serve now, the freshman for the Knights. And the ace for Wadiger.
That's a sixth, I think, service ace.
Yeah. Wow. Both teams before that had five, so five currently for the Trojans, six for the Knights. The slide, a good timing there by Berniker. Just kind of waited and waited and found her spot. Berniker gets the kill.
And that's the thing about a slide and coming around behind, the timing, you know, and making those adjustments. And it's hard to block, too, because of that.
Ace backline.
Yep.
Dropped in. So now back to even on the aces, six apiece. Right into the middle, good pace, nice touch.
And that had a hole there, went right through it. A lot of court for her swing at.
Josie Becker with two kills already, outpacing her season average. So many times in these championship matches, those who perform at a high level throughout the season, they're a known commodity. The other team's going to try to take away what they do. It's a question of who else is going to step up.
Absolutely.
There's a known commodity right there, Cottle.
excellent work. I mean, and those are the things, too. You can sometimes become one-dimensional when we got players like that. But I know both coaches have talked about, too, we got to utilize that, but we also got to help them a little bit by incorporating some of our other attackers. That will make us be more effective.
Block touch, kept it alive, bump set. Robles, good placement, saw deep corner open, and put it right there.
Great decision, knowing the defense, knowing what open areas are. It's really about control there of the ball. Just left a lot of open space down that corner. The defense is sitting in the middle.
Point for the Knights. That was four touches, did not clear the net. So Robles on that last play.
You know, that contact of the ball is key. Our body's going one direction, but again, that wrist takes it at opposite. So as a blocker, you're looking at that shoulder, but great hand control. And the other thing she does really well there is keep that hand high and that wrist away down the line.
Kinsey Jansen got caught in the net. A little tight, brush back, but the Knights are there. And the Knights now extending that lead to three.
Those tight balls are tough. They really kind of trap you in and put you in really quite a predicament there. Tough for the attacker.
Good job by Brungard. Mm-hmm. Block on the right side. There is Jansen again. Jansen stepping up here in this state championship match. It is a four-point lead, 19-15.
Absolutely, and again, what a time to, you know, to show your strengths, and she's really doing a great job stepping in and doing great work.
Not sure what to think about that.
We saw them doing push-ups earlier too. I don't know.
Well, here's a look at Robles and a 4-0 run right now for the Knights.
Well, Robles is just one of those just pure athletes. She's fun to watch. She brings a lot of energy to this team, and she's really a high volleyball IQ. I mean, we talked about that high hand where she does that wrist away. She knows where she is, her court awareness out on the court. And huge contributor right now. Leads the team with 8 kills, hitting 333.
Brungart into the block and then provides her own coverage. Tried push deep corner out of the back row. Did Andy Kaur, not there. Good dig by Kaur. Mm-hmm. Brungart again winds up and pounds it through the block.
Brungart's doing a great job on the outside. She really is. That's her 5th kill. But just, she is persevering. She's being tough up there. She's got blockers in front of her. Talked about her size, too. Hasn't let that affect her at all.
That'll be a point for the Knights. And it is now a 6-0 run for Norfolk Catholic. They're trying to even this at one apiece. Sailor Fisher will serve. G- Good up. Impressed with Addie Korn, the back row.
Yep, she's doing a good job.
And not just getting to balls, but good passes. Mm-hmm. There's an opportunity. Good pace ball out to Brungert. A little tight, so she two-hands it.
Josie Becker on that right side. Just nice rally both on both sides. Both teams doing a great job staying organized, staying aggressive.
Yeah, and then the service error by Keane. Ugh.
Yep, those are tough.
So now the Knights three away from evening this one apiece. Into the net. Two away. Here is Brungart back to serve. Coach Beller calls her one of the best athletes on the team. Tough serve. Ooh, pulled that one back in from being long. And just long on the swing on the outside. So now Grace Wortman will try to run it. Put a nice run together here, down by six late in set number two. Over pass, not down, but into the net, called on the Knights.
Like,
and they do it again, Kathy.
I like the challenge here. You know, both teams, we saw this last set as well.
Long there. And that makes it set point for the Knights. Hazing in to serve, the sophomore defensive specialist, 32 aces on the year. Goes outside, Cottle blocked. Right back to Cottle again, pulls her inside, good swipe. Free ball over, and that's why.
Trying to be a little bit too creative with that one as she's sending it over.
Big swing, wow. But not down. A good dig. Another point for Cedar Catholic. Yep.
Great tempo ball there to finish it. Roble. Good finish.
So they close it out. Norfolk Catholic wins it 25-20 in set number two to even this at one set apiece between Norfolk Catholic and Cedar Catholic. Early on, Cottle gave the Trojans the lead, but back comes Robles to take set number two.
Constellation is a natural gas supplier helping inspire young Nebraskans through hands-on learning. Constellation has given more than $320,000 to 4-H and FFA organizations across the state, helping support youth in your community with opportunities to achieve real-world success. Because we believe that powering communities means empowering our future leaders. With Constellation, a contribution to 4-H and FFA is in the stars.
This is a growing corn plant. It's not battery powered. It doesn't have a 300-mile range, but it's vital in our fight against climate change. Reducing 46% of carbon emissions and producing clean-burning ethanol. Corn ethanol is the climate solution we need now.
We're for agriculture. For growers, doers, whatever it takers. We're for doing things with purpose. We're for the little guy with big guy dreams. We're for agriculture. We're for you. Nutrien Ag Solutions.
After concussion, returning to the classroom is a priority of the NSAA. All brains return to learn. Not all brains return to play.
After recognizing that an athlete has suffered a concussion, it is important to monitor the symptoms in the classroom before allowing the athlete to return to extracurricular activities.
The NSAA requires coaches in all sports to take a concussion course once every 3 years.
More information is available on our website, nsaahome.org. Student athletes are students first, athletes second.
Coverage of the NSAA Volleyball Championships is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest Foundation, Nebraska Public Power District, Nebraska Kubota Dealers, Nebraska Corn Board, Aurora Cooperative, and Constellation Energy. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Well, it's great to have you with us here on a Saturday afternoon championship volleyball on Nebraska Public Media from the Bob Devaney Sports Center. Along with Kathy Wieskamp, I'm Larry Putney. Producer Brock Lohr, director Ryan Dobish.
And a whole host of amazing teams.
I think Donna's on camera. I think Joe's our graphics guy extraordinaire. I'm not sure who's on audio right now. Is it maybe Vanna? They're all here, though, as they always are for these state championship games. Thrilled to be able to bring them to you across the entire state. Katie Jones back at the line, serving dimes again. Mm-hmm. That goes off the block. Wadier back to serve. I was just told Hannah Sadolk is directing. This is her debut in directing.
Well,
how about that?
That's awesome. We're lucky to have her.
You know, I didn't even notice. She's doing much better than Ryan Dobish ever would have done. So it's been stellar, Hannah. That goes off the block and out.
Berniker trying to get out there, but because she didn't get turned and squared up, takes that ball off her hands out of bounds. Nice decision by the attack.
That did not clear the net for Cottle. Look at the Class D1 state rankings. These two teams, according to Mike Patterson, did such a nice job ranking teams throughout the year, trying to get to see everyone at some point. Boy, quick reaction there. Mm. Net violation is going to be called on the Trojans.
Oh, Cottle, was she threw that ball down quick. Must have followed through a little too far, too much.
Back to those rankings. Cambridge was ranked number one. Maywood Hayes Center two. Maywood Hayes Center was beaten 3-0 by Cedar Catholic. Norfolk Catholic in a tough one over Bruning Davenport Schickley, which is always a state powerhouse. Won back-to-back titles a few years ago, both in five setters. They were the victim of the Norfolk Catholic Knights.
Well, and in that match too, again, Coach Beller challenged the Knights. I believe it was in the second or third set to get to 15 before they got to 20. You know, they were down and made that effort to come back, and it was actually in the fourth set. And so that really kind of gave them a focus. Instead of looking at the big picture, getting lost, it focused it, and they came back and again pushed them on and through.
That was a remarkable comeback. And the ace.
Tough serving has really been the name of this game. Both of them really knew that was going to be key. That and defense. Both of them spoke of, again, we know the other team can hit. We've got to make sure that we're playing defense and making it difficult.
Back-to-back aces for Lady Cottle.
Cottle is on eight. Excuse me. That last ace was eight service aces.
And that one led to a free ball.
Yep. Is effective.
Good opportunity here, but it goes long off the swing of the Trojans. Point for Norfolk Catholic. From that right pin, got it down. The kill makes it 7-6 Cedar Catholic.
Nice tempo ball there, took it off, drops the ball in front of the defender, Josie Becker.
Tough serve by Berniker. Almost down on the free ball over. On the slide. Whistle finally blown, and it's going to be a point for the Trojans. It didn't look like that crossed the net.
Right.
I don't think our up official caught it initially.
And then
R2 did.
Yep, looked to down.
So here's Berniker with another serve. Better pass that time. Puts it in system, and Brunberg goes off top of the block and got the kill.
Brungard continues doing great work on that outside. And I think just the combination of different types of attackers on the outside for the Knights really gives the opponent's blockers a challenge, because they hit very differently. Blockers need to adjust and make sure they know who they have in front of them.
Brungard again into the net. Back to serve now goes Anna Keen. Double called on Norfolk Catholic. And a timeout is taken. 10-6. Cedar Catholic Trojans with the lead. Timeout taken by Michaela Beller. There's Beller in her fifth year. And there is Avery Yostin. Yostin was an important part of that Norfolk Catholic Knights squad that was down here at state, finished runner-up in 2020. She's a 6'1 junior middle who suffered a torn ACL and a dislocated knee. And she's had to deal with not being able to be on the floor throughout the year, but Michaela Beller could not have said better things about the way that Avery has handled it this year. She said she's an amazing leader. While dealing with not playing, it's been difficult, obviously emotional. Part of that runner-up team from 2020 to not be on the floor, but she's led from the bench.
Right, I was going to say, but she's got a different role and leading in a different way. And she's, like I said, it's hard.
Yeah.
I mean, but again, finding a way to contribute, and that speaks to her as well.
Tough pass or tough serving again by the Trojans lead to confusion on the other side of the net. Another tough serve by Keane. Rebound over. Right now, the Trojans are just serving nails to the Knights.
And they're giving themselves opportunities then to be aggressive coming back. Nice job there by McGregor.
Big run here by Norfolk Catholic.
Yep.
8-1 run by, check that, Cedar Catholic with the big run. Already did Cedar Catholic, 8-1 run, 13-6. And more tough serving.
And a free ball, feeding right into.
Rolled into the middle.
And you're just seeing, just seeing hesitation, not that confidence, not pursuit of ball on the Norfolk Catholic side.
And another quick timeout taken by Michaela Beller.
A great execution there, too, and game plan by Cedar Catholic, mixing things up, finding that open area, making the defense collapse on the ball. Somebody be assertive and take it.
Yep. 14-6 is the score. There is Danae Buss. I was talking to her last night. She was mentioning, you know, it's been 10 years since we won a title. That was back in 2012. And I said, well, this is how old I am. I remember when Hardington Cedar Catholic won their first state title in 89. I was down here covering it for, you know, the local TV station up in Sioux Land, KTIV. And she said, oh, I was one. Thank you, Danae. I appreciate you sharing that. So now we all can do the math, Danae, on your birthday. You were one in 89.
Yeah. A lot of good folks. Yeah.
Think about some of the, you know, great athletes they've had up in Cedar Catholic. You go back to Steph and Ryan Sanderson, the twins, who were great basketball players. Ryan had over 1,000 points. Russ Hochin, of course, the great Nebraska lineman, NFL lineman for several years, is a graduate of Cedar Catholic. Just, they have such a great tradition of athletics. Been here in the state championship six different times since 89. They've won it twice, but it's been 10 years.
Yep. And she said, too, kids have been great. They've been such a team-oriented group, you know, accepted whatever role they're given and don't question it. And she, you know, that's why they're here, you know. Just great control of the ball right now. Cedar Catholic is doing a nice job finding open spaces on the court. And they're doing it with roll shots and tempo balls.
Locks it back over and then out of bounds. This is a good, really good run for Cedar Catholic. Catholic. 16-7, largest lead of the match for Cedar Catholic. There's a swing right down the line.
Nice finish there by Core. Key was they had a pass. We're able to work with it.
Addie Core, one of those players who really, you know, she was one, didn't even make JV as a freshman, coach said. Worked hard, stuck with it, and contributed on that title, that team that made the state championship back in 2020. Great line shot again by Cottle.
Cottle is so good at that line shot. She goes up with her shoulders the opposite direction and then turns and pulls and gets on top of that ball. I mean, look at the angle.
Wow, yeah.
See that fall through, that shoulder coming around.
16 kills for Cottle. And there's Robles trying to answer. She now has 11, hitting right at 300. These shots, Robles. That serve is long. Remember that that Norfolk Catholic being down, what was it, 17-6 against BDS? You just mentioned it a bit ago. They're like, oh, we've been here before.
Focus, focus.
Let's see if we can get to 15 That's before right. they get to 20.
Yep. I mean, those are the things you just yeah. gotta, and you can't get caught up in yep. the big, you just gotta take one at a time.
Well, there is one for Robles. That's 12 kills.
You know, look at that push all the way to the outside. Great job.
Bump set to the left pin, just pushed over gently by Cottle for her 17th kill.
She just elevates so well, so she's up there, you know, look as she goes up. And the timing of that, she can, she's up there. If you go up early, then you're pulling that ball down with you as a blocker.
Into the net, can't get it back over. 10-point advantage.
And it's really been, I think the key of it has been the serve. You know, they've really, put the pressure on with the serve, or kept the pressure on with the serve, and not let him stay in the system. Wow.
Great angle, Robles with the kill. What a swing by Robles.
Beautiful shot. Talk about getting up, elevating.
And now Robles back to the service line. Good turn, Brungart's there. Run the middle, that goes off the tape and found the floor.
However you it could happen, doesn't matter.
Knight's trying to get something going here. And the ace. Another ace for Robles.
7-4. The Knights.
Second ace of the match for Robles. 5 digs, 13 kills. Great stat line.
Mm-hmm. Tough serve there, too. Good location.
Leads to the free ball. And the block on the right side for the Trojans as they extend that lead now on top 21-13. Anna Bellinghausen has more on the Trojans. Let's go down to the court.
Thanks, Larry. If you're near the Cedar Catholic bench, you can hear them all yelling, extra effort to their teammates. It's the team motto of the year, and it came about after their game against Pierce. Coach said it's all about that extra touch and hustle that separates her team, and they can beat teams with their effort and pair that with their talent, Larry.
Certainly working right now, no doubt. Up by 7 here in set 3, trying to take a 2-1 lead over the top seed, Norfolk Catholic, and there again from the right side this time is Connell.
Big swing there and a great set decision.
Yeah.
I mean, to go behind and use that right side one-on-one matchup and in system.
Becker on that last kill. Right?
Yeah, I believe.
Yep.
Yep, it was Becker.
Out of the back row. Swing is wide. Keen now to serve. Trying to find Robles all over the court. Out of the back row, the side, a big block right side. There is Kinsey Jansen again. She's quiet in set number two, but coming back on here late.
Just what they needed here, trying to get something going, get a run going.
And the ace.
Number eight for the Knights.
Three in serve receive for the Trojans, and it just dropped right in front of them. And that almost cleared the net. Set point now for the Trojans. Here is Grace Wortman to serve. Good pass. On the angle, good swing and a kill. Addie Core again.
Core, nice job making an adjustment. She got blocked. Ball get handed back to her. Takes a different angle. Finds success.
Five kills now in the match for Addie Core. Trying to close it out right here. And they do. Lady Cottle back line with the kill. And set number two goes to the Trojans of Hardington Cedar Catholic. Cedar Catholic, one set away from taking home their first title in a decade.
Sarpy County, just minutes from Omaha, offers lots of things to do this winter. For the outdoor adventurer, hiking, ice fishing, or snowshoeing at recreation areas. If you prefer to stay indoors, museums, art galleries, or indoor pools at the hotels. There's holiday gift shopping at local boutiques or one of the malls. For a holiday outing or a weekend getaway, Sarpy County has you covered. GoSarpy.com to plan your next adventure.
Constellation is a natural gas supplier helping inspire young Nebraskans through hands-on learning. Constellation has given more than $320,000 to 4-H and FFA organizations across the state, helping support youth in your community with opportunities to achieve real-world success. Because we believe that powering communities means empowering our future leaders. With Constellation, a contribution to 4-H and FFA is in the stars.
It's thanks to you that we're where we are today. We're proud to watch these communities grow because they're our communities too. Our neighbors, our friends, it's where we live. These are all our hometowns. And no matter what, the people who will continue to serve your needs with the hometown support you know and trust are just down the street. Cornerstone Bank, growing together.
Nebraska Public Media Sports presents Nebraska Volleyball. The Huskers host the Hawkeyes of Iowa live from the Bob Devaney Sports Center in Lincoln. Gameplay begins at 6 Central, Friday, November 11th on Nebraska Public Media.
Heading to set four as the Trojans have taken the first and the third to go up two sets to one, and now just one away from the Hardington Cedar Catholic Trojans winning that school's third ever state championship. They were down here in the championship match in 2018 and finished as a runner-up. 2017 finished as the runner-up. And it was 2012 when they won the last state championship. 25 points away. Good battle to keep that alive. Right into the block.
Huge block there led by Eichhoff. Right on top of the attacker.
Yeah. tough serve by Wortman. Three ball over. From behind the center, off the block and out. And again, Eichhoff with the kill.
Taking that free ball and taking advantage of it, that quick transition, running Eichhoff right behind, winning that battle.
On the angle from that left side, there is Cottle again.
Cottle just keeps coming with the high-powered offense on that outside. That's number 19 for her. She's hitting over she's about 343 to be exact.
It was in, so point for the Knights.
This is a good rotation for the Knights. Hazing does a nice job again with the serve. Got Robley up front.
Tight to the net, sit over on the second touch. Robles, she's dug. They'll run the middle. Eichhoff blocked. Robles right there with the block and a big smile.
Hands up in that high position. She was right there, but she's also very strong in that position. She locks those shoulders in. You can see how she rounds those shoulders, locks them in, makes her strong.
Could not get it, though.
Tough ball, and you can see trying to run behind, trying to keep off balance.
Good service run here by Hazing until that. Well, Katie Jones has had success from the service line here in this match. It was a real battle to start the season between Annika Keen and Katie Jones for that libero jersey. There is Core with the kill, deep corner.
Core's really done a nice job getting in there, and she generally has a one-on-one matchup, and so it's really seeing what angle's being taken away. But she adds that nice dimension.
Robles back line with the kill.
Robles was inside on that, but she just does a good job getting her hand on the ball, and then she has great hand control. We talked about getting that wrist away, high hand. Here she takes it, gets that solid hand contact.
Ace back line. Good run here for the Norfolk Catholic Knights. In the middle. Brungart right there. And then, yep, little traffic there in front, couldn't get to it.
Yep.
Meredith McGregor. Just a bit long on the serve. That'll send Addie Core back. Double called on Cottle as she tried to two-hand that to the deep corner.
Both these teams know where the opponent's open areas are on the court. They really do, and they're really working hard to try to expose those.
block in the middle. Robles like that one. High stepping it.
Squeezed right in there, got in on the action. Boy, she's good.
And the timeout called by Hardington Cedar Catholic. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from Lainey Connell.
Well, there's plenty of them. She's doing a great job out on the court, seeing what the situation is, using a wide variety of shots. She is explosive, powerful, gets up off the net. And when she swings at that ball, probably my favorite shot is her line shot. She gets on top of it, and the trajectory of that is very, very difficult to dig.
Norfolk Catholic Knights right now on a 10-2 run. Opportunity here for the Knights. Good reaction, just a quick little hand by Berniker up front, and the Trojans get the point.
And sometimes it's just making that strong move, and as it comes up to you, you don't go through a thought process, should I or not, just go. That's what she did. Oh, great.
Off the tape.
Stay with it, Bobley.
Oh, what a shot back line. Brungardt with the kill.
Beautiful placement of that ball. That deep corner is open. As we've talked, they know where the open areas are.
Powered through the block. Aggressive swing by McGregor with the kill.
Nice job by McGregor, not able to take it down, gets that inside hand of the middle blocker, kind of works on that underside of the block.
A good pass. On the middle, and the kill, Kinsey Jansen.
Jansen taking it to the left side. This time she swung the previous couple to the right. Blockers make an adjustment, so she responds with adjustment of her own.
Jansen's numbers impressive. She only has 6 swings from that middle, but 5 of those are kills with no errors. And Kinsey Jansen right now hitting 833.
Woo-woo, good job. Those are great numbers. Yeah.
Good dig.
Yes.
Brungardt tried the tight corner, but not there. Back row, just long.
Here we see that ebb and flow.
Yes.
The tide turns, yep. The momentum swings.
Second timeout here for the Trojans in this third set. So that's the last timeout for Hardington Cedar Catholic and Danae Buss. Well, how about Allison Brungardt, who's had a nice match thus far. Brungardt with 7 kills.
Well, and I think the key is that she's just done it. You know, she's been consistent when she's had her opportunities for swings. She knows, again, what she's up against as far as the block. She's finding ways to work around it, to use it. And when she needs to, she'll, you know, when you need to count on her, you can.
There are the numbers, 7 kills, 12 digs, as she inches closer to a double-double here in this state championship match. wound up and fired there. That did not clear the tape, so four touches called on the Knights, and a good timeout and a good response out of the timeout for Cedar Catholic.
Coaches get a point for that, I think.
Absolutely, yes. We keep track of coaches' points. Mm-hmm. Ace back line. Boy, that's one they just watched.
Yep. Got to follow that. Got to communicate. And I think both thought the other was going to go.
Yep. Nine service aces for each team in the match.
And they've been tough.
Right. Out of the back row, got the kill. Robles.
And Norfolk Catholic does a great job setting her up right on top of that 10-foot line so she can really come in through that ball, be aggressive, and really swing at it.
Oh, what a shot. Right on the line by Milena McGregor.
McGregor's number is really creeping up. That's 12 kills for her also.
Yeah. Here comes Grace Wortman in to serve now for the Trojans. Nice dig. Tried to go deep corner, didn't get it. That was Addie Kaur. Fifteen-11, still tight here in set number four. Anybody's one to go get and earn, and that's exactly what Chats Robles is trying to do.
She went after that ball, too. It's that quick arm swing, that quick wrist snap, the velocity that she puts on the ball, but also the angles that she puts on the ball are really impressive.
Smart dump by McGregor. Second touch.
Taking it over, she got overexcited, ready to go back and serve. Feels good to send one of those over. Energy.
Shots again, sit back. Pulled that out from Roby. Here's Robles. Robles again. And got it.
She got on top of that ball and just the angle of that. Take another look at this. Look at that elevation point and look how she is on top. The angle to get that ball at that spot. Wow.
Serve just long. Cedar Catholic on top here. Two sets to one, but trailing in the fourth, 17-3. Shank pass there. Great up.
Right on the dime.
Plays again.
The speed of the ball is just faster than the defenders. I mean, they're in the right location, but just the sharp angle and the speed. They can't get down and get underneath that ball.
18 kills now for Robles, hitting 327. She's trying to send this to a deciding fifth, but not before Lainey Cottle unloads on one. Cottle now with 21 kills.
Yep, these are two outstanding outsides battling back and forth with one another. Again, the control of the ball. I mean, she just has great control of the ball, gets her hand on the ball every time.
Yeah. Good one handed up by Brungardt. And then from off the net, knocked down by Fisher. Into the block and out, and a kill for McGregor.
Nice tool shot there by McGregor. Big blockers in front of her. So she just takes it hard off the hands and out of bounds. You can see the hands are reaching to the outside.
It is long.
Bomber trying trying for those high hands.
Yeah. Good little run here by the Trojans. Forces a timeout. So Michaela Beller takes a timeout. 19-16, up by three. Her team trying to send this to a deciding fifth. Well, you don't want to miss the NSAA football championships, which are coming up on Nebraska Public Media Monday, November 21st, and Tuesday, November 22nd. If you go to nebraskapublicmedia.org/sports, you can see the full schedule. There's live streaming available on the Nebraska Public Media app as well, and that's supported through Apple TV and Chromecast. It is that time of year, state championship time. Six champs will be crowned here today at the Devaney Sports Center. Six more on the 21st and 22nd at Memorial Stadium. You see the dig numbers for both teams.
Both coaches did talk about that defensive play. It's going to be a critical.
Yeah.
And we've seen both of them make some great plays and great shot here in that middle court, that donut area in front of the defense.
Good creativity there. Mm-hmm. Big point for the Knights out of the timeout.
Yes.
Sailor Fisher. A little tight, overpass. And down. Good serve by Sailor Fisher.
We're giving Coach Beller a point also for that timeout.
Yeah.
As we're tracking.
Again, right?
Yep, I'm helping track coaches. Good job.
In the middle again. Well, she'll get credit for a kill there.
Yep. Eichhoff doing a great job in the middle. She's had a great game. We've talked about her offensively, but too, she's doing a great job up there with the block.
For Kinsey Jansen, that is now 6 kills, 8 swings, no errors. Hitting 750.
Nice job there. Using that right side attacker. Josie Becker has been consistent over on the right side. She's got 7 kills now, hitting 455. A little over.
Back row.
Oh.
Robles again with the kill. And that is 21 now for Robles. Robles hitting nearly 350, 358 as the numbers update.
And she's had quite a few from the back row. I mean, of those 21.
We call that one in on the back line. Wortman now back in to serve for Cedar Catholic. Cedar Catholic on top, 2-1. Norfolk Catholic trying to send this to the fifth. And they're just two away from doing it. That goes off the top of the tape. And it's now set point for the Knights. middle. Going good up. Slap down. Oh, check it. They're going to say net violation on Cottle. And it's a point for the Knights, and we are headed to a fifth. Norfolk Catholic 25-18 in set number four. We've got a deciding fifth for the second match in a row. Somebody's going to win a state title here in Class D1 when we come back.
Live sports and documentaries are part of the valued services from Nebraska Public Media. Fans of high school and college sports have a great way to ensure these programs will continue. Join the Nebraska Public Media Sports Partners Club. This is your home for Husker volleyball, Big Red Wrap-Up, and high school championships. Log on to nebraskapublicmedia.org/sportspartners and explore the benefits of joining. With your support, sports action will stay right here all year long. And thank you.
Hi, I'm Christopher Kimball. You know, my television show, Milk Street, draws inspiration from global flavors.
This recipe is inspired by Middle Eastern-style whole roasted cauliflower recipes.
We want to elevate the way you cook at home.
I'm very generous with my tahini sauce. Feel free to add more.
So please join us for a great marathon of back-to-back episodes of Milk Street. We'll discover ingredients and techniques to show you that the kitchen can be the most rewarding way to travel the world. Coming soon to Create.
There's a place in the middle of America where we stand up and stand out, bringing light that illuminates the best ideas and brings change. Understanding the heart of learning comes from the heartland. Nebraska Public Media is yours, a space and community for everyone. We tell stories and amplify voices so that all can be heard, all from a place that we call home. This is Nebraska Public Media.
Nebraska Public Media celebrates five decades of social change, a revolution for women and girls, the passing of Title IX. Three-time Olympic medalist and Nebraska volleyball standout Jordan Larson headlines an all-star panel of women's athletes in Title IX, 50 years in the making. Celebrate Nebraska's pioneers who have paved the way and helped change the game in women's sports. Title IX, 50 years in the making.
Friday night at 8 Central on Nebraska Public Media.
It has been back and forth, and these two players have gone back and forth. Lady Cottle and Chach Robles, both with 21 kills. One of them is going to step up here in the fifth and lead their team to a state title.
And the thing is, the two have been battling back and forth and consistent, and their energy for their team as well. I mean, Robles, she's had several from the back row. As much as she's been effective in the front row, you can't quit thinking about her when she rotates to the back row because she's just dynamic in that position. So these two are going to really, I believe, in set number five, we're going to see these two take charge, see who comes out on top.
Well, if you're either team's setter, that's exactly where you're going, right? I mean, you're looking for Robles, and you're looking for Cottle, and you're looking for one of those two players to lead you to a state title. All knotted at two. It's a race to 15 between Norfolk Catholic and Cedar Catholic. And it's Norfolk Catholic striking first here in the fifth.
Always feels good to be the first one.
Yeah.
Especially in set five. This is a race to 15. That good start is so critical.
Cedar Catholic came from behind and won set number one on four straight points, 26-24. The answer came from the Knights. Trojans took the third, Knights took the fourth, and here we are. And there is Cottle up front, even at one. Back and forth. Robles right there.
And both of these attackers are going to have two blockers up on them. I mean, they know they've got to try and slow them down. They're tough to slow down even with two.
just long on the serve. Free ball off of the tough serve by McGregor. And the block is there. There is Robles.
I think she did, we talked about her going up strong and all that, but she also does a great job of reaching over, not so much up.
Yeah.
And that's what actually takes up more angles or takes away more angles.
Good adjustment. She saw it. It made that.
She's athletic enough to get there.
Good slide and a kill. Berniker gets it. Berniker with her fourth kill of the match, knotted at three. A little tight, kept alive. Not over though. And again, the serve of the Trojans comes up big there, and that's Cottle.
And they have Robles coming back and passing because she's so good. So she's back there to pass.
Did not get it through the block. Back and forth. No lead larger than one.
Just getting those fingertips on there makes a difference.
McGregor, and it falls on the right side.
McGregor being tough out there. She actually is second for the Trojans in kills. She has 14.
Brungard sends that wide. First two-point lead here in set five goes to Cedar Catholic. Overpass. Trojans up by three. And a timeout taken by Norfolk Catholic. College volleyball is back on Nebraska Public Media. That's next weekend. Friday night, the Huskers host the Iowa Hawkeyes. That's going to be a special one right here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center, 6 Central. It's Nebraska's 300th consecutive sellout, an ongoing NCAA women's athletic record. Then on Sunday, November 13th, Seton Hall takes on the Creighton Blue Jays. We're at DJ Sokol Arena in Omaha. That's next Sunday, 1 Central on Nebraska Public Media. Day long of volleyball here today. State champions crowned. Cedar Catholic on a 3-0 run to take a 7-4 lead. On the serve of Berniker. And that is just long.
Once again, effective timeout by our coaches.
Yes, exactly. Quick run in the middle, not down. Oh, good up by Core in the back row. But could not get it over. It is now a 4-0 run for the Trojans. Good block, Knights.
sure if it went over for sure, but the ball was there.
Yep.
Regardless.
Good quick reaction there late by Jones to keep that alive. One handed up. Free ball over.
Wow.
McGregor capitalizes on the free ball. That's Milena McGregor, the sophomore.
Just a big aggressive swing, and that's what you got to do. It's the fifth set, playing for the state championship. I love how she goes after it.
Tough serve. Another free ball.
Boom!
Cottle with the kill. And a second timeout taken here by the Knights of Norfolk Catholic.
Take a look at this again. Just the speed, the explosiveness. Straight through the block. They don't have time to get close.
It is a 6-2 run right now for the Trojans to give them this 10-6 lead. Great crowd on hand here for what was a late morning start, early afternoon match here at the Devaney Sports Center. It has been Lainey Cottle leading the way, 22 kills for Cedar Catholic.
And she's just dynamic, she's fast, and she asks for that ball, and she commands the ball, you know, on the outside. But then when she's up in the air, just her fast swing of her arm, her elevation.
Yeah.
The pace of the ball, the trajectory of the ball really are tough to handle.
Eight and three, good numbers for Cottle. Back row, Robles rolls it over, overpass. Well, good job by Jones to keep that alive. Then Cottle again. Lainey Cottle.
Stepping up to the opportunity that sits in front of her. Look at her cut that inside the block. She's got two big blockers in front of her. It's not stopping her.
And wide. And three away from a state championship now for Cedar Catholic. No timeouts left for the Knights. Bench into it. Serve for Grace Wortman. Robles from the back row.
Robles also rotating to the front row with that swing. Wow. So you're going to have both of them right now. Both those outsides.
Caught the tape and rolled. And a timeout taken by the Trojans.
The friendly roll. Both teams are in top in really good rotations for their side.
Yep.
So we got best on best right here at the latter part of this set.
First time out here of set number 5 for Cedar Catholic. They'll have one timeout remaining. None left for the Knights. It is 12-8. The Trojans 3 away from a first state championship in a decade. They last won it in 2012, the year before Danae Buss started. Buss has taken them to 2 state championships. This is the 3rd. They've been a runner-up the previous 2 times in 17 and 18. Hannah Hazing will serve as the Knights try to continue the run. And off the tape and got the kill. The throttle from Cottle got it.
And she has a pedal to the metal, let me tell you. She's coming in, she's barreling, taking that ball down the line. She's been successful there. The blockers have been trying to cut her off cross court.
Connell again. Championship point upcoming.
She is hot and on a roll here. 25 kills.
Right back to Robles they go. Bump set. Cottle. Tip. Not down. The kill and a state championship for the Trojans. Hey, we're here in 2017 and in 18 and turned away, but they are not denied in 2022. The new state champs in Class D1, Hardington Cedar Catholic.
What a great match. Two outstanding teams again, battling back and forth. We're going to the nth degree here for both teams putting the pressure on one another. Two great outstanding outsides going back and forth. Great teams playing defense. The big numbers, incredible in this match.
When we come back, medals and trophies get handed out from here at the Devaney Sports Center. The championship trophy is going to the Trojans on the strength of that arm from Connell.
Sarpy County, just minutes from Omaha, offers lots of things to do this winter. For the outdoor adventurer, hiking, ice fishing, or snowshoeing at recreation areas. If you prefer to stay indoors, museums, art galleries, or indoor pools at the hotels. There's holiday gift shopping at local boutiques or one of the malls. For a holiday outing or a weekend getaway, Sarpy County has you covered. GoSarpy.com to plan your next adventure.
Constellation is a natural gas supplier helping inspire young Nebraskans through hands-on learning. Constellation has given more than $320,000 to 4-H and FFA organizations across the state, helping support youth in your community with opportunities to achieve real-world success. Because we believe that powering communities means empowering our future leaders. With Constellation, a contribution to 4-H and FFA is in the stars.
It's thanks to you that we're where we are today. We're proud to watch these communities grow because they're our communities too, our neighbors, our friends. It's where we live. These are all our hometowns. And no matter what, the people who will continue to serve your needs with the hometown support you know and trust are just down the street. Cornerstone Bank, growing together.
Coverage of the NSAA Volleyball Championships is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest Foundation, Nebraska Public Power District, Nebraska Kubota Dealers, Nebraska Corn Board, Aurora Cooperative, and Constellation Energy. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Congratulations to Hardington Cedar Catholic and head coach Danae Buss winning the state championship in 2022. Now for medals and trophies, let's go to Steve Lemon.
The Nebraska School Activities Association, the Nebraska Coaches Association, and the Nebraska Athletic Administrators Association are proud to support positive sportsmanship during the state championships and throughout the season. At this time, we are pleased to present the Sportsmanship Award for Class D1. The trophy is graciously donated by Awards Unlimited. The sportsmanship program is exclusively presented by Concordia University Nebraska, which partners with Concordia University Irvine, California, in offering the nation's number one graduate program in coaching and athletics administration and exercise sciences. Making the presentation is Nebraska Coaches Association President Russ Neinmeyer from Douglas County West High School. The Class D1 Sportsmanship Award winner is Norfolk Catholic High School. Congratulations, Norfolk Catholic High School. The Nebraska School Activities Association is honored to have medals and trophies for both of these outstanding teams. Presentations will be made by NSAA Executive Director Jay Beller and NSAA Board of Director Dr. John Cerny from Bancroft Rosalie. Here are the awards for runner-up Norfolk Catholic High School. Head coach Michaela Beller and her assistants will present the silver medals. Players, please come forward as your name is called. Number two, J.C. Wolf. Number three, Aubrey Barnes. Number four, Kenzie Jansen. Number five, Sidonia Wattier. Number eight, Allison Brungard. Number nine, Avery Yostin. Number 11, Hannah Brummer. Number 18, Danielle Carney. Number 22, Hannah Hazing. And now, the seniors. Number six, Sailor Fisher. Number seven, Addison Kaur. Number 12, Piper Craig. Number 15, Chanity Robles. And number 17, Morgan Miller. For these outstanding athletes and their school, here is the 2022 NSAA Class D1 State Volleyball Runner-Up Trophy. Congratulations, Norfolk Catholic High School. To the champions, Cedar Catholic High School. Head coach Danae Buss, we have a special award for you. Head coach Buss and her assistants will present the gold medals. Players, please come forward as your name is called. Number two, Grace Wortman. Number four, Annika King. Number five, Lexi Eichhoff. Number six, Faith Christensen. Number seven, Ella Bowers. Number 10, McKinley Lammers. Number 11, Lindsay Hamilton. Number 12, Malena McGregor. Number 13, Lauren Berniker. Number 14, Caitlin Arns. Thank you. number 20, Katie Jones. And now the seniors, number 1, Lainey Connell. Number 8, Josie Becker. And number 9, Meredith McGregor. Presenting the championship game ball from Farmers Mutual Insurance, Director of Executive Operations, Connie Peterson. And now for these outstanding athletes in their school, here is the 2022 NSAA Class D1 State Volleyball Championship Trophy. Congratulations, Cedar Catholic High School.
State championship for the Trojans of Huntington Cedar Catholic. They are D1 title holders for the first time in a decade. When we come back, we get to hear from the champs. You're not going to want to miss it. Come on back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center.
Electricity. It makes life easier, more productive, brighter, possible. Yet we only think about it when we don't have it. The next time you're doing, well, anything, think about how electricity makes it all possible. And know we will be there, powering your everyday, every day.
It may be small, but this little bean fuels power. It powers a food industry as a source of protein. It's a fuel that powers diesel engines while reducing emissions. It powers a state economy and bottom lines. And it powers the rest of the world as a Nebraska export. Yeah, it may be small, but we're finding more ways for this little bean to power Nebraska.
Participating in multiple Nebraska high school activities has taught me the value of teamwork.
I learned how to be a strong leader among my peers.
We set goals as a team and work hard to accomplish them.
I strive to excel not only in the classroom, but on the playing field.
The Nebraska School Activities Association providing opportunities in 25 activities for our member high schools. NSAA activities, the other half of education.
Coverage of the NSAA Volleyball Championships is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest Foundation, Nebraska Public Power District, Nebraska Kubota Dealers, Nebraska Corn Board, Aurora Cooperative, and Constellation Energy. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support.
The Cedar Catholic Trojans take the D1 championship alongside Coach. What does this title mean? It's the first since 2012.
Oh my gosh, it is the 10-year anniversary, and we, it's just so exciting. These girls have worked so hard to get here, and we've really preached all season long that you're capable of this, and it was so exciting to watch them believe and actually do it.
And you do it as a seventh seed in this tournament. How much confidence do you have in your team?
Oh, so much. I mean, we have just put all our pieces together so well, and everybody is confident in themselves, and we really, showed it today. So,
what are you most proud of on the season in this game today and then throughout?
Throughout the season, just our team chemistry and the way these girls work together. Just such a selfless team. And today, really that fight, we saw ourselves get down, but, back to fundamentals and work hard. So,
And how about your assistants? What do they mean to you?
Oh my gosh, so much. They've stepped in and really helped us out. really helped me out. They are such a blessing to have with our team, and they provide so much. You provide so much. So,
well, thank you so much. Congrats. Go enjoy it.
Thank you.
We'll bring in Milena here, another key part of this win. From a student athlete perspective, what does it mean to you and the girls?
It just means a lot because this team is just so special, and we couldn't have done it without each other, and we just went in there and did what we had to do.
And in five sets,
yeah.
How much fight did that take?
A lot, but we just relied on each other, and we knew we could do it, and yeah, we tried a lot of teamwork.
Well, congrats. Thanks so much. Enjoy it as well.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Last one, Lainey Cottle. Lainey, get in here.
Hi.
You're all smiles.
Yeah.
What does this mean to you?
It literally means everything. Like, our team is so incredibly special. And, you know, we've just always talked to each other to play for each other and to play for God. And we showed it today. We totally showed it.
I know the motto has been extra effort. How did you see that out of your team today?
You know, we went out and, you know, we lost two of those sets and we had to come back and we had to, you know, we really preached about this was going to be mentally challenging. You know, it wasn't going to be, Norfolk Catholic was going to bring it and we knew that. And we went out and we just showed that we were mentally stronger than them. So it was awesome.
And you started taking over the game as well. What was working so well for you?
Meredith McGregor did amazing. Her sets were just awesome, and our passes were really getting there, and so they were able to put the ball where I needed it, and so it was based on them. So,
and I'm sure you heard the crowd all game long. What does the community mean to this team?
It's everything. You know, they have come to everything, and our student section is just awesome, and you can always hear them. They're always cheering loud, and it's great to have that behind us.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Appreciate the time from those folks. D1, Cedar Catholic, your champions.
So congratulations, thanks very much, Anna. It is Cedar Catholic winning it 15-8 in set number five. They are the state champs in D1.
Title IX, 50 years in the making.
Nebraska Public Media supports those who have driven miles of Nebraska highways. Those who have paid their share of admission fees. Those who have worn their school colors faithfully. Those who have practiced. And those who have stood on the sidelines. Nebraska Public Media supports those who have supported Nebraska high school athletes.
Title IX, 50 years in the making.
There's a place in the middle of America where we stand up and stand out. Bringing light that illuminates the best ideas and brings change. Understanding the heart of learning comes from the heartland. Nebraska Public Media is yours, a space and community for everyone. We tell stories and amplify voices so that all can be heard, all from a place that we call home. This is Nebraska Public Media. There's a place in the middle of America where we stand up and stand out. Bringing light that illuminates the best ideas and brings change. Understanding the heart of learning comes from the heartland. Nebraska Public Media is yours, a space and community for everyone. We tell stories and amplify voices so that all can be heard, all from a place that we call home. This is Nebraska Public Media.
Take a look at some highlights from the D1 title game, Cedar Catholic and Norfolk. Boy, Cottle was so good.
Lainey Cottle finishes with 26 kills, hitting 236. She was just on fire. But mixing it up,
yep.
Being dynamic, hitting a lot of different locations, a lot of different shots. And look at that energy she's providing her team, that confidence that she has out there on the court as well.
when it was championship on the line, Laney Cottle stepped up. Her team, Cedar Catholic, hit 278 in the fifth set to negative 125 for Norfolk Catholic.
And across the net, Roble, just again, yep, another dynamic outside attacker, does so many things well. She's just athletic. And again, look at that attack, the energy that she also provides for her team. Again, a tough battle between two outstanding outsides. And again, a great match for us to have the opportunity to watch.
And then in set five, it really was,
you know, Cottle.
Laney taking over now.
I mean, she had the hot hand. She stepped out there from her first swing and said, we are doing this. And her presence on the court and her attitude out there, you know, and again, obviously her performance lended to that happening. And again, a championship for Cedar Catholic, first in 10 years. What an exciting time for them.
So you look at the final numbers and Cedar Catholic hits 201 in the match to 170 for the Knights, but it was, the difference was really in the fifth set. That's where it was.
Right.
There was a big difference.
And again, it's the timing of that. We talk about that too, when those things happen, because we saw a lot of ebb and flow through this game. Both teams, the service aces, were incredible. They came out on a mission to serve, to control the offense.
So once again, your state champs in 2022 in Class D1, the Hardington Cedar Catholic Trojans. Stay with us.
Art was one of the powers that made life life. I think we all believed that.
This is a real life story of a real live person.
This was my only connection to my culture.
Fight the battle.
Our stories deserve to be heard.
You're passionate and you respect your heritage. That is a perfect recipe.
Now is the time for the reformation. Now is the time to rebuild the nation.
That's amazing.
You're making me cry.
Some girls can go out there and just steal a spotlight.
This is the moment that we've all been waiting for.
Everyone has something to contribute to humanity. The arts are the thing that does that.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
Coverage of the NSAA Volleyball Championships is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest Foundation, Nebraska Public Power District, Nebraska Kubota Dealers, Nebraska Corn Board, Aurora Cooperative, and Constellation Energy. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Well, in terms of quality matchups and late game heroics, we are 2-for-2 down here at State. We've had 2 5 setters in D2 and D1, and I don't know why you would not want this for a lifetime. So if you'd like a copy of our DVDs of the NSAA Volleyball Championships in Class D2, D1, or any throughout the day, just give us a call at 1-800-868-1868. Or you can visit us online at nebraskapublicmedia.org. It's just $19.95 plus shipping and handling, and you can relive those two exciting 5 setters in Class D1 and D2 for state championships for years to come. Let's take a look at what has passed and what is upcoming throughout the rest of today on Nebraska Public Media. We began this morning at 9 a.m. and got a 5-setter between Howells Dodge and Overton. Howells Dodge wins it in the fifth, 15-12. Grace Baumert had 42 kills on 106 swings. She hit 311, and they go back-to-back. Howells Dodge, the Jaguars, win their second consecutive. And then the one that just completed, it was another 5-setter, 15-8. Cedar Catholic in the fifth, their first title since 2012, and Laney Cottle with 26 kills. You see what we have coming up? Next, it's Bergen and Lincoln Lutheran, Gothenburg and GICC. at 3 o'clock, although now that we're about 2 hours, about an hour and a half behind, it's going to all be pushed back. We'll see how the schedule goes. But tentatively, these are the estimated times of these state championships from here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. We'll close it out tonight in Class A with Westside and Papillion La Vista South. Along with Kathy Wieskamp, I'm Larry Putney. Glad you could join us here for these state championships. We've got a good one coming up here in that a team looking for an undefeated season.
I mean, undefeated, going unblemished for a full year is very difficult. Yep. And they play a very difficult schedule. Lincoln Lutheran here, number one, 39-0. They're trying to keep that a perfect record intact. Also won Sue Ziegler's first back-to-back state championship.
Right, right. So they are 39-0, trying to go 40-0. We've got that coming up for you in Class C2. Once again, the final score, it's Hardington Cedar Catholic winning the state championship 3-2 over Norfolk Catholic. For Kathy Wieskamp and Anna Bellinghausen, I'm Larry Putney. For our entire sports production crew, thanks for watching the NSAA Volleyball Championships on Nebraska Public Media. C2 is coming up next.
Next time on Midsummer Murders.
Never worn a pair of boxing gloves in my life.
When a famous bare-knuckle brawl is recreated.
And come out fighting!
The people involved start getting killed.
Any signs of a struggle at all?
None.
And the clues point to brute force.
So he could have been knocked unconscious before he was killed.
But Barnaby can't keep up with the body count.
Oh, would you look at that.
Midsummer Murders.
Thursday night at 9 Central on Nebraska Public Media.
Art was one of the powers that made life life. I think we all believed that.
This is a real life story of a real live person.
This was my only connection to my culture.
Fight the battle.
Our stories deserve to be heard.
You're passionate and you respect your heritage. That is a perfect recipe.
Now is the time for the reformation. Now is the time to rebuild the nation.
That's amazing.
You're making me cry.
Some girls can go out there and just steal a spotlight.
This is the moment that we've all been waiting for.
Everyone has something to contribute to humanity. The arts are the thing that does that.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
They've transformed their French chateau.
This has been so tricky.
But for Dick and Angel Strawbridge, the problems never stop coming.
It's a massive project.
It's going to be a really long night.
From renovations to whimsical creations.
I've had an idea. It could save us money.
Discover what happens when fairy tale meets real life.
She always wants to do more.
On Escape to the Chateau.
Monday night at 9 Central on Nebraska Public Media.
So when I was growing up, I didn't have cable. And so I watched a lot of Nebraska Public Media, and I grew up watching Between the Lines, and it was part of what made me really passionate about reading. And so I spent a lot of time at the library, and now as an adult, I listen to NPR and Nebraska Public Media every morning and every day I'm driving my neighbor kids to school and stuff. And so it's been an important part of my everyday life since I was a little kid. And it's so important to support our public programs like that because they provide us information for free and education and entertainment, and it's a really valuable resource.